John Divine in New York City, and singing Christus Factus Est by Bruckner, which is really, really hard, and they sang it so well. Jammer and Mission.
Yeah.
And given that the quality of our performance that day was superb, it really was. It was an incredible experience for me through. Brandon, for admission. So, we're so glad you could be here with us tonight for the outcome, sort of the centerpiece of our program, Mozart Requiem. We do the Mozart Requiem every 4 years here at WJ because it's one of those life-changing works. You're never quite the same after you sing the Mozart Requiem. I distinctly remember the first time I sang it. I was a junior in college. And it's just an incredible piece of music. I think part of what makes it so meaningful is that when Mozart was writing this, at the ripe old age of 35, he actually began to feel, as he was composing it, that he was writing this Requiem for himself, that he was going to die. A Requiem Mass is a Mass that prays for the souls of the dearly departed. And he began to feel that this was a Requiem for himself. So when you hear this music tonight, you are hearing the last music that Mozart ever wrote, because he did, in fact, die before the Requiem was completed. And one of his students then finished it. There's a lot of debate about whether the student maybe had worked with Mozart and knew how he intended to finish the work. But at any rate, you will be hearing the last notes that Mozart ever wrote. And knowing that he himself felt he was dying, this is sort of his vision of the afterlife and what comes next for him. It's a very powerful work, and we are very pleased to present it for you tonight. Give us just a couple minutes to reset.